Hello and welcome to QuickerSim CFD Toolbox tutorial number 7, steady state heat transfer in a two component material. Today we will be discussing heat transfer through a brick that has been insulated with some styrofoam. Now, the physics of this simulation have already been discussed in the tutorial concerning generic heat solver 2D. However, here we are going to show you how to introduce another material into your mesh and to define its properties. So let's actually go to MATLAB for a second to display our problem. This is done here. We're simply reading mesh and scaling it by a factor of 1,000. This is done to convert the units from millimeters to meters. Perfect. So as you can see, we have defined two materials during the mesh generation stage of the problem. The yellow elements represent styrofoam and the purple elements represent the concrete. This is done simply by assigning the material ID of 90 to these elements, the yellow elements, the styrofoam elements, and a value of 89 here for the purple elements. And this can be viewed in the T array defining the mesh. So as you can see, some of the elements have the ID 89. These are the concrete elements, and some have the ID 90, which are the styrofoam elements. So next we're going to assign different thermal conductivities to these two materials. This is done in this section. We're simply going to first assign the value of 0.35 to the concrete elements and 0.03 to the styrofoam elements. Now these particular values have been defined in this PDF. In this paragraph, you can download this PDF from quickersim.com, or you can download it directly in your toolbox GUI. So let's run this section now. And next, we need to move the values from the elements to the nodes. This is done by calling this function with a pretty descriptive name. And next, we're just going to display what happens. So as expected, the styrofoam parts have a thermal conductivity value of 0.03, and the concrete ones have a thermal conductivity value of 0.35. Next, we're going to build the problem matrix. This has already been discussed several times in the previous tutorials, and apply the boundary conditions. Now, the boundary conditions have been described also here in this PDF. In this paragraph, you can find equations and physics describing the boundary conditions. Here we use the Robin boundary conditions, also known as the third kind boundary conditions. So we need to define the heat flux through the boundary and also the temperature at the boundary, or of the medium behind the boundary to be more specific. And as you can see, we're only applying these boundary conditions to edges 86 and 87. These are the top and bottom edges. The side edges of the geometry are going to remain insulated. So let's apply those now and solve a problem and also display the solution. Great. So you can see the effect the insulation has on the problem. Now, of course, naturally, if there was no insulation, if the entire brick was concrete, you would see simply a gradient that is the same across the entire problem. And here you can see that these contour lines are not straight. They're somewhat twisted a little bit. And generally, you can see very well how the insulation has affected our problem. Finally, we are simply going to display the energy balance in our problem. This is done in the final section. So this is the incoming heat flux and the outgoing heat flux. And as you can see, they're equal within computational accuracy. And as you can see also, the flux through the insulated surfaces is very small. This concludes our tutorial. Thank you for tuning in. If you'd like to learn more, please visit our website at quickersim.com. Please also check out our YouTube page and our social media for more updates and news. Thank you and goodbye.